December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy. United States of America.
On December 7th, 1941, America found itself forced to defend freedom in nearly every corner of the globe. Jazz would go to war too, and swing, still America's most popular music, helped to remind the men and women of the armed forces of home. Bandsmen today are not just jazz musicians, said Downbeat magazine. They are soldiers of music.
I think the swing era and all of those great band leaders of that period reminded Americans, at a time when they were willing to be reminded, of what was unique about the country, of what a democracy was. It's no accident that Benny Goodman and Artie Shore were Jewish, or that Count Basie and Duke Ellington and Jimmy Lunsford were black, and that white audiences were responding to. The whole country was making a hero out of Benny Goodman. Well, this was a big thing at that moment, and it reminded everybody that there was something special about this country. And when the war started, it became even more underscored, because the war, in a sense, was about, you know, ethnic cleansing. And jazz became identified, it epitomized the American spirit. The spirit of freedom and swing. And, you know, we are a young, vibrant nation. The way we dance represents us. The way we listen to music represents us. This was purely and uniquely American.
But on the home front, the music industry faced daunting new obstacles. Blackouts darkened nightclubs and dance halls. Late night curfews and new cabaret and entertainment taxes, as much as 30%, kept still more customers at home. The rationing of rubber and gasoline drove band buses off the roads. And servicemen now filled the Pullman trains, making it difficult for musicians to get around by rail. A shortage of shellac curtailed recordings, and companies stopped making jukeboxes and musical instruments altogether for a time, because they were deemed unnecessary to the war effort. The country needed weapons now. The draft stole away good musicians and forced band leaders to pay their replacements more for less talent. I'm paying some kid trumpet player $500 a week, Tommy Dorsey complained, and he can't even blow his nose. But swing endured, and its irresistible tunes became the anthems of wartime America.